Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check.
Check.
So, it's a show?
It's a lifestyle. It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Later. In addition of all of the shows that I'm watching, I'm also watching at night some GTA players, you know, on Twitch, French ones, and you know, I need to sleep sometimes, so during the day I'm trying to watch the replays of their games, and right there they're all wiping their characters and I'm like, why everyone is being killed? I don't understand. It's too much for me. I think that I have too much characters, you know, to get involved with characters in shows, in animes, in movies, in things like that, you know, GTA, Grand Theft Auto, for those of you who don't know. Things, you know, and I'm also watching Dungeons and Dragons things, you know, games, because people are posting their games, because it's well done, made with actors and actresses, so it's really well done. I love too much to get involved with characters, like, maybe I have an addiction with that. Whatever, you know, the thing, Twitch with Grand Theft Auto, YouTube with these Dungeons and Dragons games, shows and animes and movies, books, I have an addiction with that. I did not say hi, right? Hello! Hi, I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch Legend of Korra season 4, episode 5. I watched this morning the episode 4. If you want to see my reaction video about that, I'm gonna put the link into the eye. Guys, it's a better light, right? I watched the first, you know, the videos of what I filmed this morning. I'm so sorry for that, you know, for the light, but I couldn't predict it. And you know, with this winter weather, it's really hard for me to plan my schedule. I don't know really when to film anymore, and we have a weird weather this winter, like right now it's really cloudy and I think that I'm gonna have a storm, when this morning it felt like we were in June, you know. Sorry, I'm talking about the weather. Okay, about what happened during the last episode, we didn't, I mean, yes, we left Toph at the swamp, but we didn't say goodbye to her for good. Okay? You can't make her come back into the show. Like, no, no, no. First, you can't talk about her during a season and not showing her. You did it. That was already weird, in my opinion. You're making the viewers wait for the new season to come. You're making some episodes with her, but you're not making her do what the viewers are expecting for her to do since seasons. And the obvious thing, in fact, that her character is supposed to do, like, it's not only to please the fans, it's also like the character needs to do that for her own development. It needs to happen. She didn't see her daughters since so many times. I mean, maybe Sue, she doesn't need that meeting because she reconciled with her mother. She said stuff about that. But Lynn, for sure, she needs to meet her mother. Lynn, she needs to see her mother. They need to talk about their lives, you know. I mean, Toph, I'm sure that you chose everything into your life. Like right there, to be all alone, to be such an independent person and all. It's you, Toph. I recognize you. You didn't change. You're just doing what you want to do, and you're glad to not have to respond to anyone, to anything. I mean, for someone as free and savage like Toph, like we met her during Avatar The Last Airbender, I'm sure that being the head of the security of Republic City during all of this time, it was okay for her because she wanted to help to build Republic City, and that was the best role, you know, for her to do, because you can't imagine her doing diplomatic things, but you can imagine her being tough and being like, okay, things are like that, you're gonna respect them, or I'm gonna do stuff, you know. I can imagine her doing that and all, but you know, to have all of these responsibilities, it's not her neither. So I'm sure that when she retired, Lynn said that it was because of Sue, because after what she was forced to do for Sue, she was never the same after that. Like, she had the impression that she betrayed her responsibility, you know, her place. And maybe it's right, but I think also that it remained in her the fact that she's not like that, she can't be just like that, and she just wants to be free and to do what she wants, and that's what she's doing right now. So I'm glad, Toph, that you're doing that, and I'm sure that Sue, she doesn't need really a reunion, but Lynn, she needs it, because Lynn, she followed the steps of her mother. I'm sure that she lived good days and she only did stuff that she wanted, but that path at the beginning, I'm not sure that she chose it for the right reasons. I want a discussion between these two. I think that it can be important, you know, for Lynn's development, like, she needs it. I don't know what can happen during it and after it, but I think that she needs it, that conversation. So that's why I want Toph back. Okay, I want also a reunion with Toph, Zuko and Katara, and also maybe Iroh. Okay, I want her back also for that. I'm not gonna lie. But come on, I'm honest right there when I'm telling you that for her character, Toph, and for Lynn's character, we need to have more about Toph. She can't disappear just like that. Korra is back at being the Avatar. That's cool. We need the Avatar because we learned during the last episode that this army is gonna try to reach Zaofu. I'm worried about that. You're gonna attack? No. You can't attack directly, but at the same time, you can't blackmail, make a deal like you did with the other cities, with Zaofu, like... I really don't want that to happen. I want Korra to intervene. You need to understand what that soldier is doing right there. The fact that she's really trying to replace the power in place, which can be a good idea when you think of the fact that all of the persons of this family only did bad stuff, in fact, when they were at the power, and that was a dictator, you know, like, that was not just a royal family ruling. They were making rules, you know, for this kingdom, rules of a dictator. Manipulating people. People are not equals, are not free, they are afraid. That's not great at all, and it's still the same right now. I have some hope, you know, with Prince Wu, with what we said during that scene with Mako. I think that maybe he can change, he can begin to care about his kingdom, about his citizens. I prefer to put my hope, you know, on him than on this army, because that woman, she knows what she's doing. She knows that she's manipulating these persons. She knows that she's taking all of these places by threatening people and manipulating them. And I'm disappointed that Bolin... Oh, I'm sorry. I'm disappointed a little that Bolin is following her. I know that she's focused more on the fact that they're giving food to people, that are helping them and all, but how can you not see all of the bad stuff that she's doing and how she's doing all of that? You need to see that, Bolin. Opal, she tried to tell you that, but I hope that during this episode, if we're gonna see that attack during this episode, I hope that you're gonna see it, Bolin. You know this city, you know these persons. Little news about Zuko, possibly meeting Iroh? I'm gonna watch 3 episodes this afternoon. Maybe I'm not gonna have the reunion today, but I can have news about Zuko at least. No? And you know, I'm also trying to find a reason to go into the spirit world. I need to go, I need to see Iroh. I need to see him. Okay, I'm gonna stop this intro right now. Like usually, if you want, you have my Patreon on which you can have the episodes earlier. For The Legend of Korra, it's a lot because we have 4 episodes of Advent. It's a lot and it's with extended or full action parts. Check the description and check also the schedule post that I make each Monday on YouTube, Patreon and Twitter to see if I post the extended or the full reaction part. It's the best way to support me. If you can't join us on Patreon, you can still like, subscribe, comment. It helps also. Let's go for this episode 5. Do you? Yes, I have a tissue. I was thinking, you know, 3 episodes, potentially I can cry. Yes, I have a tissue. Oh, and I also have my tea and some cookies that I made and that maybe I'm gonna eat. Winter, you know, cookies and tea, that's the minimum. You can't do that!
By this time tomorrow, my mother will have signed our treaty and the Earth Empire will finally be united.
United? How can you come back?
Securing your hometown won't be like every other city.
Securing? Conquering?
I'm ready to take it by force.
We must do this right. That's why we need Bolin.
You're gonna manipulate them using Bolin?
Bring back to Republic City. If Kuvira's heading to Zafu, so am I. She needs to know that the Avatar is back. The world needs to know.
Yep!
In this stasis capsule is a preserved spirit vine sample weighing approximately 2 Julies.
3 Julies!
It's working. It's registering 5 barracks of power. Now 7 barracks.
Julie?
Shut it down.
Are you okay? She was touched, no? Shut up! Up her! What?
Lyric, you saved me.
What?
Of course I saved you. I can't clean this place up by myself!
Were we attacked?
No!
She's still with you because she has feelings for you?
Do you realize what we can do with this kind of
thing? It makes sense.
Yes, I do! Usually I look at a project like this and all I think is, wow, I can make a ton of money off this. But recently I've been having these strange feelings inside, nagging voice in my head constantly, telling me what's right from wrong.
I believe that voice is your conscience, sir.
Yep.
I'm telling you, you will continue this project.
Sorry? No. I just really gotta stand my ground on this one. Whoa!
Now that she's beginning to do things right.
That voice is a liar.
Julie? Okay, let's not free her, but let's...
The summoner came.
I'm here to return these.
You never opened up. I can't forgive myself for all the horrible things I've done. And I never expect you to forgive me. You're the one thing I look back on that makes me smile.
You can be proud of...
I just want you to know I'm so proud of you, Asami. You are the greatest thing I ever created.
Oh, Sammy, you need to hear that.
In fact, I have good news. We want you to be a part of our inner circle.
Bolin.
Are these troops going to send the wrong message?
The army is here to present.
Bolin!
You're here to present peace.
You've chosen your side.
Sides? There shouldn't be sides. I know. Why don't we all stand in a circle, huh? Maybe hold hands.
Sue, I didn't bring my army to threaten you.
Not at all!
All that your son and I have accomplished.
Son. You belong here. Why? So that I can go on living in your shadow.
Set him free. And now he's accomplished more with me than he ever could have with you.
Obviously, there's a lot of personal...
I'm suffering inside.
You have 24 hours to agree to join the Empire or we take the city by force.
Buddy! Wake up!
You were just bluffing, right? I mean, you're not really gonna attack Zafu. Are you?
But when people don't cooperate, we must find other ways of convincing them to join.
She did that before, but he
used these other ways in the past.
It's not for you to worry about.
I'm not really an inner circle kind of guy.
Or maybe we don't take over Zafu. We could just let them be on their own. Then yay, the Empire's united.
I didn't know your personal feelings for Opal were stronger than your loyalty to me.
Zafu
will join us. Maybe you need to spend some time in a re-education camp.
What? She has her own daily re-education camp.
She was like a daughter to me. I saw myself in her.
The problem.
What happened?
You're the perfect person to take charge. The world leaders trust you. And as a Beifong, you have credibility in the Earth Kingdom.
I think you should do this. Zafu has always been a beacon of modern progress, and now you can share that with everyone.
We'd be seen as conquerors and greeted with nothing but war.
There are already wars. The earthquake nearly destroyed our nation. This is our opportunity to change things.
I see why she thinks that, you know, Kuvira. But not like that.
I knew it was only a matter of time until she made her way back here. I want to fix this. You can.
How?
Go into the Avatar state and demolish her army.
No.
Let me talk with Kuvira. Maybe I can reason with her. Kuvira doesn't listen to reason.
She can try.
I'm running out of air. Julie, hold your breath.
I'm not holding my breath.
Great! Now we're both gonna die!
Barak!
Oh! And the head voices are back!
Hold your breath so you can
act. Where did that hatch come from? Forget the hatch! There's something important I gotta tell you.
You're gonna...
Kuvira's crazy!
You're gonna escape together?
I built her a super weapon. She threatened my life.
She threatened me too. I can't let you take Zafu. Look, I was tasked with bringing stability to the Earth Kingdom. Why should I treat it differently than I
did? You didn't do that.
What you're doing isn't right.
Mm-hmm.
In order to fix it, I had to make some tough decisions. I know what that's like. I've had plenty of people mad at me about decisions I've made. If you really want to help, go back to Sue and try to talk some sense into her. Let's call it temporary truce.
Okay, I say we go up and around the mountains and sneak into Zafu from the rear. We're not going to Zafu. That place is doomed. We gotta head to Republic City. Let me think about this.
Oh, Julie. I see you now, girl.
Sorry, your mission is very difficult.
Yes, Julie. It was so cool! So cool, so good!
Stop! Turn yourself over or else. Thanks a lot, Julie!
I wanted my words to hurt you so that you would know how you hurt me. But when I saw you, it wasn't anger I felt. It was sadness.
I want to make amends.
I'm not sure I'll ever be able to forgive you. But that doesn't mean I shouldn't try. I thought we could play some pie show. Like we used to.
Nothing would make me happy.
She believed in second chance. Some people with regrets. Mwah.
Oh. Send these three away on the next train.
Quick tears.
Bowman and Julie will be going to the re-education camp for our most severe dissent.
Please, have mercy on me. Don't send me away. Take me back.
I was blindly devoted to Varric, and I looked past all the times he ridiculed me because I thought he possessed the most brilliant mind in the world. Compared to you, Varric's a fool.
Hey, come on, I'm right here.
And I believe in your vision.
No, 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 I was beginning to buy it, but the fact that she says all of that about you.
I'll give you another chance.
We have history!
I did everything you ever asked of me, and you never appreciated it.
I can't buy it.
I have to talk to her.
She's not here. She took wing and way. They're going to sneak into Kuvira's camp and put an end to this.
No.
By avoiding a combat, you know, a war. I'm divided. I don't want them to do that because they want to fight, maybe to kill Kuvira. Not to kill with the story that she said, so I'm not sure that she could kill Kuvira. In fact, I'm okay with their plan. You know, now that I think about it, Sue's plan can be good. She wants to avoid a fight, she wants to avoid people dying, and she wants to try something to stop only Kuvira. And again, I don't think that she could kill her. That story that she says, you know, their background. I understand what Kuvira said, you know, during that memory. Sue could have been a good ruler because she did great with Zafu, and she could have done also great with the Earth Kingdom and to help it, you know, to rebuild it and in a progress way, you know, like to bring modern stuff to it, to help people. But I understand also that Sue didn't want to do that, like it was not her place. You know, it's really like Amon and Zaire. I said during the first season that Amon, he set things right about the fact that people were not equals, that people with bandings had superior places and the other ones, then something was wrong just right there. And when Amon disappeared, you know, I was like, maybe he helped you to see that, maybe you're gonna change stuff after that, but they didn't. And Zaire, I said it also, what he did, the fact that he wanted to free people, the fact that he destroyed this world in Ba Sing Se, and all he wanted people to be free, to be equals, again, I agreed with that. I agreed with their ideas, but not how they were doing that, for sure, by using violence and choosing to kill people and all. For sure, I was not okay with that. So that's why during the last episode, I appreciated when Toph, she said that to Korra, telling her, maybe you could learn something from your enemies, what they wanted. Maybe there is something right there that you can work on. And right there for Kuvira, it's almost the same. Like at the beginning of everything, she wanted the Earth Kingdom to be rebuilt, to be reunited, and someone to guide them in the right direction, to help them to be a better country, a modern one. Can we blame her for that, you know, because she wanted that? All of what she's doing, you know, because of that idea, how she's deciding to do that, it's wrong. But the idea at the beginning was good. Bullying, the fact that during all of this time you didn't see that she was manipulating people, that she was threatening people, that she was forcing them to sign that contract, you know. She was not reuniting Earth Kingdom, she was conquering each part of the Earth Kingdom little by little so she can rule Earth Kingdom like... No, not Earth Kingdom, because kingdom means royalty. Her empire. She built her empire. How can you... How didn't you see that, Bolin? I'm glad that at the end you're finally realizing all of what she did, but it took you a lot of time. And even when you were entering into Zafu, when you saw all of this army, you were just like, maybe it's not the right message to send. No, no, that's not enough, Bolin. You should be like, oh, what are you doing just right there? Of course you're threatening them by putting all of your army in front of their gates. Trying to talk with Sue, that was a bad idea, of course. Of course it was not gonna work. Korra's back could have been a good idea, but Korra, who is lost, who doesn't know what to think anymore, who wants to do good without fighting, but doesn't know also really the situation, like she didn't see really what Kuvira did and how wrong it is. That's bad. That's so bad. I don't think that she can help right now, in fact. Korra. Okay, she's the avatar and all, but right now, I'm not sure that she can be the solution of that situation. It's episode 5. Are we gonna let Kuvira take Zafu to avoid a battle, to avoid death? We can't win against her army, and we don't want a battle no matter what. We're gonna let her take that place. This re-education camp, come on. This re-education camp, they're exactly the same than the daily camps when there were brainwashing people during Avatar The Last Airbender, or when they were forcing people, you know, to be their slaves, to be their soldiers during Korra. I don't know if it was season 2 or 3, but we already saw that also during The Legend of Korra. Fuck you and your re-education camp brainwashing people, like right there, it's not. You're brainwashing them. This re-education camp, they are for the people who don't believe into your ideas, so at the end they're gonna believe into your ideas. Brainwashing, that's what we call a brainwashing. Julie, Julie! During all of the first seasons of The Legend of Korra, each time I was like, poor Julie, really poor girl. She's forced to work for that guy. He's so annoying, he's treating her bad. And during this season, the beginning of this season, I was beginning to be like, but why is she still right there? Like, I was saying she's forced to work with him. So is she his slave? Like, why is she forced to work with him? Maybe she's doing that for money. Like, I tried to find answers about that, but without really thinking about it. She accepted that because she wanted to be there, because she has feelings for him. She admires him so much. My free Julie transformed itself in just 5 minutes into a situation like free not cheap. Can I ship them? No, I'm not gonna ship them. He doesn't see your feelings, for sure. He never saw you, not really. He always used you and mistreated you. But I'm not buying at all that at the end Julie could switch just like that. Even if, you know, I would have bought all of the "I'm tired of him, he's useless, I don't appreciate him anymore, and in fact he's just using me, so that's it, I don't want to work with him anymore." I could have bought that part, but the fact that she said after that all of these things about "you're the right person, I'm gonna be loyal to you, I'm fond of what you're doing and all, like go 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 Kuvira," no. No, no, I'm not buying it. You can't accept during all of these seasons what Varric did to you to just switch just like that in some seconds and to take your love for Varric and put it on Kuvira just like that. No, I can't believe so. Julie has feelings for Varric. If I could have imagined that. But really, it makes sense now that I think about it. During all of this time, I was just like, poor girl, she's forced to be there. Why is she there? It makes sense now. She's not forced. She wants to do that. And that's why she's accepting all of that. Because she admires him, because she maybe loves him. Oh, I need to stop to lie to myself. I mean, how I was during that fight with Julie protecting him like that, you know, with her reactions, and how I was cheering during that moment. Oh, I think that I ship them already. It's weird because clearly I'm not a fan of Varric. I never hide it, you know, like, okay, he's a funny character. Okay, he made me lose a lot, but we can't trust him. He can switch just like that, you know, for money and all. Oh, maybe not anymore. During this episode, he said that he has a conscience, something telling him to not do that because it's wrong. And he's listening to that conscience. Varric, do you have a sense of morality now? Maybe I can trust you if it's a case. So maybe I can ship you with Julie if it's a case. Why? Oh, that's it, I'm shipping them. I can't lie to myself. How many minutes it took me to just switch from "I can't ship them" to "I'm gonna ship them"? Not even 2 minutes, I think. I'm gonna put it right there. Okay, I'm gonna watch 2 more episodes today. It's all for you for today, and it's all for me for now, so bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?
Great.